But I would say broadly, I think of kind of four things in my mind that have been really successful. One is it works. It actually achieves the valued outcomes that people want in education, whether that is reducing use of exclusionary discipline, increasing academic achievement, increasing social emotional capacity, like emotional regulation, and also increasing racial equity in school discipline, attendance, a huge range of educational outcomes. The second is that the practices they don't require a whole lot of training or certification or advanced specialization. What we're really talking about is just really good instructional practices that typical educators can do and are comfortable with and are using, instead of saying we need this outside person to come in and work with us. Number three has been this really strong focus on systems for implementation. So instead of saying, here's a program, here's a curriculum, here's a practice, you teachers just do it, and then kind of leaving them on their own to implement, we say, what are the things that our educators and leaders need to be able to put that into place? And whether that's team-based implementation, coaching, getting feedback systems for and using data, whatever those are, we want to make sure that we've got an active role in implementation, not just a handoff. And then I would say the fourth one is this approach where we stick really tightly to the core features or the big ideas or the active ingredients or the ways that make PBIS work without having a really tight grip on what that looks like in practice. So meaning we don't insist that everybody does PBIS the same way. The local tweaks and examples and contextualization is really important as long as people are doing it within these guidelines of what are the parts that are most likely to make it work. And those are, you know, sometimes we would call those core features or critical features of PBIS. So those four things I think of in a nutshell.